and I commit with Hindus. Oh, Hindus all over the world, it's my commitment to you. In Washington, D.C., I have seen a Jewish Holocaust museum with that same standard, presenting way. I will make a museum telling the story of Hindu Holocaust to the whole world. I am committing to Hindus. This is my commitment to all of you, all Hindus. I'll make a museum. This five commitment I am going to make to all you guys, and I will fulfill it. I will not die before fulfilling these five commitments. One, how Jews have told their story to the world, the persecution and the Holocaust they went through to the whole world, especially through that museum in Washington, D.C. I think there is a street where all the museums are there. There, Hindu, the Jewish Holocaust Museum is there. I'll tell you exactly which street. Same way. I don't know whether in the same street or somewhere in Washington, D.C. I'll do a museum presenting all the facts of the Holocaust Hindus are going through to the whole world. Hindu Holocaust Museum. Worst Holocaust, at least 10 times more than Jewish Holocaust. We lost lives 10 times more. I should say it must be more. I'll bring all the historical facts and documents, evidences to the eyes of the whole world through this Hindu Holocaust Museum. That's one. Second, I will make sure there will be a Broadway show in New York on Ramayanam and Mahabharatam. Establishing Ramayanam and Mahabharatam is history of Hinduism. They are not just some poetry or itihasa or literature. Sorry, itihasa means actually history. It's not just some poetic literature. It's a history with all the evidences, facts. Astrological, botanical, geographical, we have multi-layer evidences to prove Ramayanam and Mahabharatam is a history. With this context, like how the Lion King show, all those shows, Broadway shows are there, same way in that standard, I'll make sure there will be a show, regular show, to demonstrate to the world the Hindu history based on Ramayanam and Mahabharatam. I will establish the most authentic, world's largest physical and virtual library and Hindu University. Hindu literatures are made illegitimate, stolen. Many concepts and principles and ideas are stolen. And Hindus are made to feel that literatures are all just mythology and faltu and just somebody's fantasy. I will make sure enough scientific researches are done, proper documentations are done, analysis are done. Not only I will collect, compile, organize the world's largest Hindu knowledge resource library, I will make all of it user friendly for the whole world by making virtual Hindu library available for the world. I already started the work. Last 20 years I am doing work in this line. Actually, all my gurus, whatever they have done, they have transmitted that knowledge, idea, vision to me. And I myself started working on my mission for last 20 years. It is time. In next few years, you will see the fruit. I'll make world's largest library. Please understand. World's largest library on Hinduism. The physical library and virtual library. Understand? Literally, last, I can say 50 years, Hindus do not know how an authentic Hindu university would have existed. They can't even imagine. I will make sure an authentic Hindu university which teaches power manifestation, science of Hinduism, astronomy, astrology, enlightenment science, Hindu physics, Hindu chemistry, Hindu medicines. You should know very clearly, Ayurveda will not work if you separate it from Hindu faith. Hindu belief system. If Ayurveda is separated from the Hindu belief system, it will not work. I will prove with scientific studies and researches. Only if you believe in reincarnation theory, many of the Ayurvedic medicines, life-saving drugs will work on you. Hindu faith has its own unique, powerful way of manifesting a unique physiology. Ayurvedic medicine system is designed for that. That is why I call it Hindu medicine. And I tell you, reviving all this, I cannot do in India because Indian constitution does not allow this. You need to know that. I want to bring all the Hindus all over the world, your attention to the Indian constitution. Article 30 in the Indian constitution of India, 1949 says, let's project. The amount of suffering I went through, torture I went through, in the hands of anti-Hindu elements and anti-Hindu media, because I started running authentic Hindu Gurukul, they literally destroyed and separated me and my Hindu Gurukul in India. But I want to tell you guys, tell you Hindus, oh Hindus all over the world, don't worry. Fortunately, I am not dead. Paramashiva has protected me. Kalabhairava has protected me. Kalabhairava is protecting me. Paramashiva is protecting me. Oh Hindus, I want to tell you guys, I really commit with you. Fortunately, with the grace of Paramashiva and Kalabhairava, we found a nation which has given us already land with autonomous status. The treaty is officially signed. I will not announce which country, which place now, because I am doing all the basic infrastructures needed. Once it is all completed, I'll announce. I don't want anti-Hindu elements to come and harass me and disturb my work. But I want to tell the Hindus all over the world, Hindu diaspora all over the world, I will preserve and protect the Hinduism as described, detailed in Vedas and Agamas and Puranas. The original authentic Hindu tradition, undiluted by politics or anti-Hindu elements, without any corruption, pollution, I will preserve and protect and promote the original Hindu sciences as it is. In this place, I have formed, I am reviving Kailasa only for this purpose. I will gift the Hindus the world's largest Hindu library and Hindu university. My initial level plan is 10,000 students will be able to reside and study. 2 crore. Means 20 million Hindu scriptures and largest virtual library, very organized and made user friendly. Fortunately, last 20 years of hard work from me and of course my sannyasis and my Kailasavasis, they all have done extreme hard work after being beaten, abused so much from multi-level. We have done so much hard work and we are successful now in organizing ourselves. Soon you will hear the good news and the address where you can come and study peacefully. I am going to follow, I commit now itself with you guys, I am going to follow the Hindu economy principles. Education is free. We beg from people. We ask, request, beg people to fund. We ask people, please give us Guru Dakshina. But no one will be denied education because they don't have money. No. No economical reason will stop you getting educated. Now itself I commit with all the Hindus all over the world. This whole Kailasas NHU, Nityananda Hindu University, physical campus or virtual university, digital university, both will function with the principle. Hinduism believes strongly, knowledge is free. Guru is supposed to beg from people all over the world. And whatever he gets by begging, with that, he has to teach and support students. Please understand, not only knowledge will be free, while you are staying in campus and studying, we will provide all your basic needs, food, stay, clothes, and medical care, all your other bodily maintenance needed, like a housekeeping maintenance, everything. As per Hinduism, all of that will be provided free, free of cost. I am going to follow, bring legitimacy to Hindu economy principles in every level. Paramashiva says very clearly, some things should be given absolutely free. Like a medicine, education, all these should be absolutely free. There are some things which can be bartered, like a sharing, exchange basis. Some things which can be sold. So as per Paramashiva's economy policy, we will run Kailasa. Soon, I will give my third gift, world's largest Hindu university, physical and online, digital. I really want Hindus to understand we have great things to contribute to human civilization. We are contributors, whether in the field of physical health, mental health, consciousness-based sciences, power manifestation, enlightenment. Hey, consciousness is actually wealth. You can expand it and manifest it and manipulate it and make your life comfortable, luxurious, better, even wealthy. You can manifest all the four powers, see, four natural forces: gravitation force, electromagnetic force, soft nuclear force, strong nuclear force. All the four forces, you can manifest it, pull it out of your consciousness. It is verily possible. I will make all these sciences as commonly available to all of you as Anazin Metazin or Netflix movies. How? Just by one click you can get Netflix movies or YouTube videos. I'll make all these sciences available that common to all of you through this virtual Hindu University. And I want to put this on record. Many of my sannyasis, successful, actually Nityananda Hindu University is formally headed by one of my sannyasini, Ma Nitya Mahavidyananda. She is actually not only PhD, she used to be guiding PhD students in Seattle. She used to be working in University of Washington. A large number of educated, successful sannyasis have gathered and made this Kailasa Nityananda Hindu University possible. Thanks to my sannyasis, even after being so much beaten, mob lynched, boldly going all over India, village to village, not only all over India, even up to Nepal, they travel in all the difficult, dangerous places like Palghar, they travel and collect all the Hindu scriptures, scan, digitize. Do you know, some places, the Veda Patashalas, the Vedic Patashalas, those priests, after seeing the work we are doing, they say, Swamiji, please take this whole original leaf. We are gifting it to you. Let it be with you, because at least it will be safe for humanity. which when we will be killed, all these will be burnt, we don't know. So at least let this knowledge be safe with you for humanity. They gift it away because they are understanding their next generation will not be having food to eat if they continue to live just this Veda Patashala lifestyle. In India, all other religious institutions get funded by government, but not Veda Patashalas. All the money from Hindu temples are sucked away by governments, but they don't fund a single penny to Veda Patashalas. Shivoham level 2, the program is happening. I told I'll do a major 5 contributions. I spoke only about 3 as on now. Only about 3 I have spoken, and I'll describe the other 2 detailed in the further satsangs.